Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I know it has been a while, but today I have a very interesting video on how I colored my hair at home. I'm not even going to give the longest intro because I am actually talking about the product step by step as I'm doing it. So you will see the most information you can in the video. So I'm not even going to say that as of now. But if you're interested in watching how I color my hair at home, then let's jump right into it. For a few of you that haven't seen how my natural hair looks, it is very, very curly and very, very frizzy. That's one of the reasons I don't like having a very light color, because it does look more dry. Few of you that have been following me on Instagram know that I've actually not been very happy with the blonde hair that I've been having. I actually wanted a very, very specific color for which I had to get my hair bleached, but the only issue is when you get a bleach done to your hair, after maybe 3 to 4 weeks, your hair will definitely get lighter and blonde again. So you have to keep going and retouching it. And that's something I actually realized much later on, and I didn't want to go back and redo it again and again. Firstly, because it does cost a lot of money. Secondly, I'm not sure of the brand they are using. All I go in is like, this is the color I want, this is my hair, work your magic. I don't know what brand they're using, what chemicals go in that product. So this time I decided to take matters into my own hands, and I ordered this product, Herba Tint, from iHerb. I got the shade Dark Ash Blonde. Growing up in boarding school, it was very, very common. All of us used to pack our hair colors, go to school and color each other's hair one by one. So this goes way, way back for me. So I don't want to waste any more time because I feel like I have been blabbering for a while now. But I just want to read a couple of things that come on the packaging, just so I and you, in case anyone's interested in purchasing this on iHerb, know what exactly you are going to be expecting. Herba Tint Permanent Hair Color Gel covers your gray effectively while taking care of your hair, all thanks to the gentle and unique formula. A carefully balanced formulation, result of rigorous testing, achieving for each shade the perfect color result in the most gentle manner. And here are all the 8 herbal extracts that are in this product. So it contains of 1 Herba Tint Hair Color Gel, 1 bottle of Developer, 1 sample of Royal Cream, which I found it in the box, and 1 leaflet containing the directions and use. So I opened this box hoping to find the gloves, and I was just like, why don't they have any gloves, until I opened the leaflet and the gloves are literally stuck to it. I've never seen something like this. Oops! I've never seen something like this. Can you see that? How cool was that? Sorry, I get impressed with the most stupid things, but preparing your hair, do not shampoo your hair at least 24 hours before coloring. I did shampoo my hair last night. I don't know if that counts, but Your natural oil protects your scalp from irritation. However, your hair must be free from any residue of hair styling products or treatment. Okay, just the generic stuff. Combine equal amounts of the color and developer, ratio 1:1, and mix until you obtain a gel consistency. So I actually have this bowl which I'm going to be using to create the mixture. One is the hair color gel and one is the developer. So we're going to mix these two up and apply it on my hair. I'm actually firstly going to color my roots first, because it's much darker than my hair at the bottom, and if I do this first and then this is gonna be even darker. So I'm gonna go ahead and color my roots first, and then I'm gonna go in with the end. I'm going to just take the hair color gel and can you guys see that? It's very, very liquidy and water. It's a very weird consistency. I've actually never seen a hair color of this consistency. Okay, so the other one is the developer, which is also, it's literally like water. So I'm just going to use the spatula. It says to mix the hair color until it turns into a gel consistency. I do see the texture changing, so I'm guessing it's the mixture of these two that's thickened up the product. But it's looking quite red here, which is really scaring me, because I hate, hate, hate on my hair. The color is turning darker, so that's a good sign. It's less red, more purple. What is happening? Whoever eats eggs, just beat an egg. This is how you beat an egg, guys. So this is how you beat her button. Okay, let's get going. Let's start with the roots. So I'm gonna just section my hair one by one. Sorry guys, my battery died as soon as I got started. I honestly did waste a lot of time blabbering at the start. But I'm just gonna take some and apply it on my roots. And then section it. Okay. If you guys want an easier way, or if you guys have one color on your full head, literally all you can do is massage it and slowly put in like top to bottom to top, and then just keep combing it so the color is spread out evenly. But because my roots are much darker compared to like my hair, can you guys see the difference? I really need to go with my roots first and then go with my hair color. Every time I look at my every time I'm looking at myself in the screen, I'm just like, dude, what are you up to? But I've just applied the hair color on my root, and I'm just gonna wait for maybe around 10 to 15 minutes to let that color just latch on properly, and then I'm gonna apply it to the rest of my hair. The texture feels really, really weird. I've actually never had a hair color like of this texture. It feels like I've put a really hard hairspray and I can't move it, but it's like wet, if that makes sense. Like my hair's not moved, like apart from the dry bit, like if I just put it there, can you just see it just sticks? So it feels like it's a hair wax or a hair mousse that's just holding on to the hair. This looks fun and pretty. So it's been about 15 minutes. Now I'm just gonna color the rest of my hair and then let the whole thing sit for another 20 minutes before I wash. And then I'm just going to color my hair and massage the roots, just like you would do it when you go to a salon. And then just comb it once so the color is spread evenly. Massage it. Comb it. Combing it down. Now what I'm gonna do is just put everything at the back, and whatever is left in this bowl, which is quite little, I'm just gonna mush it around and massage it all over my head. So any spot that I feel has gotten missed in this procedure, at least that way. You know how like you apply oil? I'm just gonna do that. I have a very, very tiny amount remaining, so I'm just going to put it at the ends of my hair. Make sure to literally cover as maximum hair as you can. So I'm just going to roll my hair up now and let it all mix together and create, you know when you tie your hair in a bun, it actually creates warmth. So I feel like that warmth is gonna bring out the color even better. Now I'm just gonna leave my hair for another 20 minutes and then we're gonna wash it, and I will check back in here to show you guys the end result. Hi guys, I am back again. My hair is freshly blow dried, and surprisingly it's so soft. So you must have seen in the video how my hair literally became so stiff, and I was just like, this is no way gonna become soft. But I was really surprised. The conditioner that came in with the packaging was a dream. It literally changed the game, and I really hope I can purchase that somewhere. It was so nice. I'm sure you must have seen the before and after of how my hair was and how it is now, and the color is so seamlessly blended, and I personally really like it. It's not as blonde as it was before, and it's much more even in color, and I did all of this at home. So I just quickly wanted to show you guys how my hair looks, and the color is way more even than what it was, and it feels really, really soft, and I really like the color. So I just pulled out my phone just to let you guys know how much the product was, because obviously I forgot. So I paid $107.99, so $108. $108 for a hair color like this at home. What more can you ask for? I haven't done this in a long time, but let's get into the drill. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. If you want to see more of my videos, please click the subscribe button, and I will come out with a lot more videos. And I really hope you enjoyed this one today, and I will see you all very, very soon. Bye.